Photoshop is an incredible tool for editing and enhancing your photos. And one of the most powerful tonal tools it offers is the Curves tool. Whether you are using the Curves panel in Camera Raw or Lightroom, or the Curves adjustment layer in Photoshop, this tool is truly one of the best in the business. At first, it might seem a little intimidating to use, but don't worry, with a little perseverance, you will quickly master this powerful tool and be rewarded with stunning results. The curve line in Curves represents the tonal range of your image, with shadows on the left and highlights on the right. By dragging points of the curve line up or down, you can lighten or darken different parts of the tonal range. If you shift any part of the line above the original diagonal, it means that those areas of your image will become brighter. Conversely, if you shift parts of the line below the diagonal, those areas will become darker. Adding contrast is a great way to give your photos that extra pop and make them stand out. Luckily, Curves can help you achieve this easily, and one of the best ways to add contrast is by using an S-shaped curve. Now you might be wondering how this works. Well, the S-shaped curve essentially darkens the shadows and brightens the highlights, creating a greater difference between these two and increasing the contrast. You can control the strength of the contrast by dragging the top point further up and the bottom point down. The higher you move the top point, the brighter the highlights become. The lower you move the bottom point, the darker the shadows become. But what if you want to fine-tune which areas are affected by the curve? This is where making the S-shaped top or bottom heavy comes in. By doing this, you can control whether the shadows or highlights are affected more strongly by the curve. You can also control the brightness of the midtones by adding a third anchor point in the middle of the S. This allows you to adjust the brightness of the midtones without affecting the shadows or highlights. Overall, using an S-shaped curve is an effective and flexible way to add contrast to your photos. Give it a try and experiment with different settings to see what works best for your image. If you are looking to give your photos a stylish and trendy matte look, Curves can help you achieve that also. It's actually quite easy. To create a matte effect, all you need to do is flatten out the whites and blacks in your image. You can do this by dragging the very bottom point on the curve line upwards to flatten out the blacks. This will make the darkest areas of your photo appear less intense and more muted, which is the key to achieving a matte look. Similarly, you can drag the very top point downwards to flatten the whites. This will make the lightest areas of your photo appear less bright and more subdued. The result will be an overall flattened look that's perfect for creating that popular matte look. Remember, you can adjust the strength of the matte effect by dragging the points up or down until you achieve the desired look. Now that you know how to create a matte look using Curves, go ahead and give it a try on your own photos. You might be surprised at how easy it is to achieve a trendy modern look with just a few adjustments using Curves. If you're feeling adventurous and want to experiment with colors in your photos, Curves can help you achieve some amazing creative color shifts. By switching color channels in Curves, you can add different hues to your photos or even correct unwanted color casts. The red channel lets you add red or cyan. The green channel lets you add green or magenta. And the blue channel lets you add blue or yellow. To add color shifts to your photo, you can drag parts of the line in the Curves panel to affect colors in different sections of the tonal range. You can also drag the very top and bottom points up or down, left or right, to tint the highlights and shadows with different colors. This is a great way to add a subtle color shift to your photos without affecting the entire image. Overall, curves give you complete control over the colors in your photo, allowing you to create unique and eye-catching effects. So, don't be afraid to play around with the different color channels and see what kind of creative color shifts you can achieve with the curves. Do you know that you can use curves selectively in your photos? With the help of mask panel, you can make targeted adjustments to specific areas of your image. Let's say you want to adjust the brightness and contrast of the background in your photo without affecting the foreground. You can create a mask for the background and then apply curves to the selection. This way, you can selectively alter the brightness and contrast of the background while leaving the foreground untouched. Similarly, you can use curves to tint the selected area differently. For example, if you want to make the sky in your photo more blue, you can create a mask for the sky and then use curves to add blue to the highlights. Selective curves can be a powerful tool in your editing workflow, allowing you to make precise adjustments to specific parts of your photo. So next time you are editing a photo, don't forget to try out this feature and see how it can help you to take your edits to the next level. In conclusion, curves is a powerful tool that can help you enhance your photos in many ways. Take some time to experiment with it and see what works best for your photos. And that's it for this video. I hope you found this video helpful. If you want to see more tutorials, tips, and techniques, make sure to subscribe and turn on notifications. Please don't forget to like, share, and comment on this video. I can't wait to share some more tips and tricks with you in the next video. Until then, take care. Happy editing.